Find the axis of symmetry for the parabola defined by the equation y equals x squared plus 6x plus 5. Just a quick review, if we have an equation for a parabola in the form y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, then the equation x equals negative b over 2a is that axis of symmetry. Okay, so let's pick off these numbers right here. We've got our a value in our equation is 1, that coefficient of x squared. Our b is equal to 6, and our c value is 5. We won't need the c, but just to complete that part. Okay. Now we let's find this equation of the axis of symmetry. So we have x equals the opposite of b. So the opposite of 6 over 2 times a, which is 1. So simplifying that, we have x equals negative 6 over 2 is negative 3. That's our axis of symmetry. And that'll be a vertical line. I'll show that in a little bit. First, let's talk about another way to do this. And that is, if you have the equation in the form y equals some coefficient or something multiplied by this x minus h quantity squared plus k, then the vertex of the parabola is going to be at the point hk. All right, so let's do that. Let's complete the square of this parabola and get it into that form. So I'm going to say y equals x squared plus 6x, and then I'm going to leave a space here, and then plus 5, and that's just finishing the rest of this equation. Okay, to complete the square, we take half of this coefficient of x and then square it. So half of 6 is 3, and then 3 squared is 9. So to complete the square, I'm going to add 9 here. Now, if we were completing the square to solve a quadratic equation, we would add 9 to the other side. But we're not really solving an equation here. We're just making this equation fit this form. So here we can add 9 and then come right over here and subtract 9. And that's that is perfectly fine to do that, because what we're doing there is just adding a net of 0 to this side of the equation. So I added 9 and then subtracted 9. Okay, now we're going to partition this part off and rewrite that as y equals x plus 3 quantity squared, and then 5 minus 9 is minus 4. Okay, notice that this says x minus h. Well, we can play that game. We can write the plus 3 as a minus a negative 3. And that's okay. We're not changing the value at all. All we're doing is saying minus a negative is the same as a positive. So we're just rewriting it so it fits that form. So we have an h and a k. And again, we could also write this minus 4 as plus a negative 4 if we'd like to fit that plus k. So we have a vertex then for this equation, for this parabola, of negative 3, negative 4. That is our parabola, or our vertex of our parabola. So let's come over here, negative 3 and negative 4. Put that point right there. I'm going to use a bright color. Okay, and it's going to look something like this. I may miss some of the crosshairs perfectly, but that's a rough sketch of what the parabola is going to look like. The vertex will definitely be right here. Okay, now what have we been looking at this whole time? This axis of symmetry, and that is the x equals negative 3. Okay, that will go right through the x value of negative 3. And I know it doesn't ask for us to graph this, but just to give this visual, this is our axis of symmetry. This x equals negative 3 defines this line here. Okay, so we found the axis of symmetry a couple of ways, and we've also graphed that parabola.